E3 is right around the corner, and a lot of questions still remain as to what we can honestly expect to see from Nintendo this year. Before we step into the uncertainty of their E3 2019 plans, let's go over how Nintendo has actually framed their E3 presence since the Switch's launch. Following its successful March launch, the road to Nintendo's E3 in 2017 was a rather simple one. Secure the already robust first-year lineup that included the likes of Legend of Zelda Breath of the Wild, Mario Kart 8 Deluxe, ARMS, Super Mario Odyssey, Fire Emblem Warriors, Mario & Rabbids Kingdom Battle, and Xenoblade Chronicles 2, while also announcing future upcoming titles that turned out to be the likes of Metroid Prime 4 and Kirby Star Allies. With so many games in its first-year lineup, it didn't take much of a Nintendo fanboy to realize that not only had they won E3, but that a solidified mixture of ports and brand new games evenly spread out throughout the year was a winning formula. However, in 2018, questions started to rise up as to what would Nintendo feature for the Switch's second year in the market. At the Game Awards, they confirmed that Bayonetta 3 would begin production soon, and in their first major direct of the year in March, they revealed both Mario Tennis Aces and Super Smash Bros. Ultimate, giving a small glimpse of what 2018 had in store for hungry Switch owners, which by then were demanding for much more. During Nintendo's E3 in 2018, they revealed Super Mario Party and confirmed a late fall release for Pokémon Let's Go Pikachu. Pikachu and Eevee. Teaming it up with the December launch for Super Smash Bros. Ultimate, this drove fans to question Nintendo's strategy even more, since the early half of the year was filled with ports like Bayonetta 1 and 2, Hyrule Warriors, and Donkey Kong Country Tropical Freeze, and Kirby Star Allies being the only new game release in that time window. But that didn't signify that it was the dark times or there were droughts, as some speculated. Nintendo secured the second half of the year with Mario Tennis Aces and Octopath Traveler releasing in the early summer, followed by Super Mario Party, holding over Switch owners until the fall releases of Pokémon Let's Go and the massive launch of Super Smash Bros. Ultimate, which was Nintendo's 1-2 punch for the holiday season. Even so, ultimately, the lineup simply couldn't stack with what we saw back in 2017, and unlike in that year, we were clueless as to what releases we'd actually see up until around E3. This led to rampant speculation if the lack of new games in 2018 was the price we had to pay for such a stacked 2017 lineup, and moreover, if it was worth the cost. This gets us to 2019, where seemingly the situation is similar to what we saw back in 2017. Expectations are extremely high for Nintendo's 2019 lineup, but unlike in that year, the devil is in the details, or specifically the lack thereof. This past December at the Game Awards, Nintendo revealed Marvel Ultimate Alliance 3 and followed that up with their only game-focused direct of the year in February, revealing The Legend of Zelda Link's Awakening, Super Mario Maker 2, and the release dates for Astral Chain, Fire Emblem 3 Houses, and Marvel Ultimate Alliance 3, meaning that the summer window of game releases is confirmed and dated with those three titles. But the first half of 2019 was again, just like in 2018, very lackluster, only seeing the releases of New Super Mario Bros. U Deluxe and Yoshi's Crafted World after already getting delayed out of 2018. All of this leads us to this upcoming E3, where the talk of almost a dozen titles to be shown is all well and good, but I have some reservations. Starting with Daemon X Machina, where it already had a beta event, and Marvelous has stressed as recently as 2 weeks ago that it's still a summer release game. This after already getting delayed out of Q1, just like Fire Emblem Three Houses, a game that was delayed twice into a summer release. All we've seen of Luigi's Mansion 3 was the September Direct reveal teaser, but that hasn't stopped Nintendo from calling it a 2019 release game. Out of all of the games we can expect to see at E3, this is one that wouldn't surprise me if it gets delayed. Pokemon Sword and Shield are no doubt Nintendo's massive fall games. Based on Korokoro's information, they'll be sharing new details in their June issue. This confirms we'll be seeing more of the game during E3, and hopefully this time around the Pokemon Company can give us more details than just the starters. The remake of The Legend of Zelda Link's Awakening was one of those out of nowhere reveals in February's Direct, but like many of these games, there's plenty of questions that remain, like what's the actual scope of the project other than just a visual style change? People have brought up the questions of price, if it can honestly be a $60 game, seeing how it's just a remake of a Game Boy game. This is one of those titles that I not only expect Nintendo to give us a trailer at E3, but go into depth during one of those Treehouse streams so we can actually see if it's truly a 2019 release. Town from Game Freak was announced in last year's September Direct, and we haven't heard anything about it since, except that is another one of these mysterious 2019 releases. By this point, I hope you're starting to pick up on the pattern. Metroid Prime 4 was flat out restarted and the reins of the project were handed over to Retro Studios, so we probably won't be seeing anything of it until around 2021. But that hasn't stopped people for asking for a Metroid Prime trilogy port, which in general makes a lot of sense, but I would question releasing it so early. It would probably end up being another Bayonetta situation, where the first two titles came out over a year and a half ago by now, and 3 is still nowhere to be seen. Speaking of Bayonetta 3, after its reveal at the Game Awards, it has been shrouded in mystery. First, around mid-2018, Platinum revealed that the team had been formed and production was underway. This was months after the original reveal. Then, a few months ago, the director Hideki Kamiya confirmed that the production plans were different this time around when compared to the first two games, since they learned a lot from making them and they had changed their production process for the third title, something that he hoped fans would notice. This has led to plenty of speculation that if it's in fact another 2020 game and not a 2019 title like Nintendo has stated. Shin Megami Tensei 5 was announced back at the original reveal of the Switch. Yup, it was really that long ago. And it's still not out. In October of 2017, Atlus put out a quick trailer, but since then it's been all quiet from their front. With the heavy demand of Persona 5 on Switch, and Atlus already working on both Persona 5 R The Royale and overseeing Persona 5 Scramble The Phantom Strikers in collaboration with Koei Tecmo, it's quite unclear just how far this project has come along in all of the time that transpired since we last heard about it. Animal Crossing was the hype reveal during the September 2018 Direct, and like I've mentioned several times already with other titles, we haven't heard anything about it since. Most people expect it to be in collaboration with Pokemon Sword and Shield, the heavy focus of Nintendo's E3 efforts, while also promoting it heavily in the second half of the year for its eventual fall release. All of this brings me back to my original point. There's a lot of games we can expect to see at E3. Sure, there's no doubt about that. But there's also major questions in some of these high-profile titles. There's no doubt that the summer is stacked, but fall and winter are just, if not more important, when it comes to console sales, if you're to use Nintendo's own quarterly sell reports as a guide. In their confirmation for their E3 plans, Nintendo mentions that they'll only talk about 2019 games, but of course that's not quite accurate, since in the past they've revealed games for the future while also making that same statement. But what was interesting is that they specifically said they'll be talking only about software, nipping in the bud the idea that they could reveal some sort of revision, be it the Switch Mini or the Switch Pro. This is also backed by statements from Nintendo's president Shuntaro Furukawa from just last month, where he stated that they had no plans to reveal a console revision at either E3 or in the near future. This means to me that it's probably closer to a late 2019 reveal in tandem with a Pokemon Sword and Shield bundle, but clearly outside of anything relating to E3. The last thing, of course, are brand new unannounced reveals, games we didn't previously know about. The Nindies effort has been something Nintendo has been pushing for more and more as they make up for almost half of the entire Switch's library. A highlight reel of a few high-profile indies wouldn't surprise me with games like Haven, Young Souls, Risk of Rain 2, and Darkest Dungeon 2. The notion of Nintendo touting even more Wii U titles at this point in time is something I don't think most people will be too excited about, especially after what we saw them do last year. That still doesn't stop the possibilities of games like Tokyo Mirage Sessions FE, which is a game that honestly deserves another shot after releasing to little to no fanfare. The Wonderful 101 is a game that got a few teases on Twitter, but a port is something that we're anxiously still waiting for. Xenoblade Chronicles X has actually been discussed by Monolithsoft, where they basically said that a port would be expensive, meaning that if one ever actually comes, it would probably be because Nintendo ponied up the money to get it done. And of course, Pikmin 3, which you can't really mention without also mentioning Pikmin 4, a title we've been hearing so much about for such a long time, and one that never actually materialized. I'd actually be surprised to finally see the series reintroduced, but it most certainly would be a welcome addition. There's talk of Monolithsoft already staffing up for their upcoming Zelda project. Then there's the rumors of that mysterious Retro Studios project that was speculated to be the Star Fox Racing game we heard so much about during last year's E3. And of course, all of the talk about Nintendo taking over projects like Scalebound in collaboration with Platinum Games, where Nintendo would essentially take over the license of the game series while Microsoft still owns the rights to the IP. Speaking of Microsoft, there's been plenty of rumors and hearsay about them doing something with Nintendo, starting with the ever-beating drum of Banjo and Smash, either it being ports of their games to the hybrid console like Ori and the Blind Forest and Super Lucky's Tale, or perhaps something more interesting like Halo Collection. That's not even to mention the ideas of their added technical support to the Switch, with Xbox Live services coming over and even Game Pass to a certain extent. All of which are interesting scenarios, but purely speculative until an actual reveal. Anyway, so that's my video. I hope you guys really enjoyed it, and be sure to leave a like and subscribe and hit the bell to receive notifications when my videos go up. See ya!